वेलकम टू वीलर्न। वीलर्न में आपका स्वागत है। सब्जेक्ट फाइनेंशियल इंजीनियरिंग, सेशन नंबर 6, फ्यूचर्स कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, डेरिवेटिव एंड रिस्क मैनेजमेंट। टॉपिक कवर्ड इन दिस सेशन, बेसिक कंसेप्ट, स्पेकुलेशन, आर्बिट्रेज, हेजिंग, मेकिंग टू मार्केट मार्जिन अकाउंट एंड नाउ स्पॉट एंड फ्यूचर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट। फ्यूचर्स कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इज एन एग्रीमेंट टू बाई और सेल समथिंग इन द फ्यूचर एट ए प्राइस एग्रीड टूडे। देयर इज ए स्पॉट कैश एसेट्स अंडरलाइंग द फ्यूचर्स कॉन्ट्रैक्ट कैन हैव ए फ्यूचर्स रिटर्न ऑन लाइव हॉर्स ऑयल स्टॉक्स। लेट एस इक्वल टू स्पॉट और कैश प्राइस, एस इक्वल टू प्राइस फॉर डिलीवरी टूडे इन कैटल मार्केट। फ्यूचर्स प्राइस एफ आर कॉन्टिन्यूसली कोटेड एंड चेंज फ्रॉम सेकेंड टू सेकेंड, बट इट इज द फ्यूचर्स कॉन्ट्रैक्ट यू आर बाइंग एंड सेलिंग, नॉट द अंडरलाइंग एसेट्स इट सेल्फ। नाउ फ्यूचर्स कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, फ्यूचर्स प्राइस एफ जीरो इक्वल टू रुपीज 100 ऑन लाइव हॉग्स, कोटेड टूडे 1st January विद डिलीवरी मंथ इन सेज सेप्टेम्बर, बाई इक्वल टू लॉन्ग फ्यूचर्स। Agreed a legal contract to buy the underlying, that is one live hog, in the delivery month at F0 equal to rupees 100. If the contract is held to maturity, sale equal to short future agrees to sell the underlying one minus live hog in the delivery month at F0 equal to 100. If the short contract is held to maturity, you will be notified by the exchange a few days before the maturity date of the contract that on your particular contract delivery is going to take place, in order that you can have your hodge ready and looking good. Now future contract, no payment made today, only a deposit to a guarantee you will not quit on the deal. This is known as a margin payment and is not the future price. This means that futures provide leverage in that a speculator can enter into a futures contract whose value changes with that of the underlying stocks, but she does not have to spend any of her own money at t equal to zero. The clearing house futures exchange act as an intermediaries between buyers and sellers and keeps a record of all transactions. Analytically, care must be taken to state whether your analysis involves holding the futures to maturity or buying then selling prior to maturity. Why does F change between 1st Jan and 1st Feb? As we see later, arbitragers ensure that F changes as the price of hogs change in the spot market S. If S increase falls, then F will increase fall. Almost rupees 1 for rupees 1 over short horizon, that is 1 to 3 months. And now forward contract and future contract. Private non-market contract between two parties, delivery or cash settlement at expiry, usually one delivery date, then no cash paid until expiry, negotiable choice of delivery, date size of the contract. Whereas futures traded on an exchange, contract is usually closed out prior to maturity, range of delivery dates, and cash payment into out of margin account daily standardized contract. Now financial future market. Money market instrument 3 months euro, rupees deposit 90 days US treasury bills, 3 months sterling deposits, bonds, US treasury bond, UK gilt and German bonds, then stock in indexes, S&P 500, FTSE 100, then currencies like DM, sterling, yen, mortgages pools GNMA, Life, CBOT, IMM, CME, NY Futures Exchange, Philippines Exchange, Singapore Exchange, Hong Kong, Tokyo, Pacific and Sydney Futures Exchange. Now futures, most contract are closed out prior to the maturity or delivery date. See also hedging letter. Note that if on 1st January you bought a September futures contract at F0, then you can get out of this contract before maturity simply by buying this SEP future contract on sales 1st Feb at whatever price F1 is being quoted for the SEP contract on 1st Feb. Then nobody delivers anything at maturity. Who uses futures? Speculation with futures, buy low, sell high risky, negged open position, hedging with futures, that is in Jain farmers, want to lock in sale price of his hogs, which will be fed by SEP. And Jain, he sells hog futures at rupees 100 with maturity date of SEP. If he hold contract to maturity, he delivers his hogs in SEP and receive the rupees 100 for certain, that is even if hodge in spot, cattle market are selling for rupees 10. Arbitrage. Spot and future price are linked by the actions of arbitrages, and S and F move almost one for one letter is useful for hedgers like this one. Future price quote, corn 500 BU, cent per BU. Open September 182 by 1/2, December 194 by 1/2, and March 206 by 1/2. High 183 1/4, 195 2063 by 4. Low 179 1/4, 191 1/4 and 203. Settle 181 1/2, 192 1/4, 204 1/4. Minus change 2 and 1/4. 2 and 1 by 2 and 2 and 1 by 4. Then lifetime high 265 and 1 by 2, 279 and 1 by 2 and 279 key power 3 by 4. Then low 178, 1 by 4, 190, 202. Open interest 1,32,493, 1,76,843. Then 37,875. Now speculation with futures. Purchase at F0 100, hope to sell at higher price later F1 equal to 110. Close out position before delivery date. Obtain leverage, that is initial margin is low. Example, Legion 595, long 61,000, Nikkei 225 index. Future underlying value rupees 10 billions. Nikki fails and he lost money, lots of it. He was supposed to be doing riskless index arbitrage, not speculation. Now arbitrage at maturity. At expiry T, we must have FT equal to ST, otherwise riskless arbitrage profit could be made. That is, suppose one day before maturity, FT 100 greater than ST 98, then buy low at 98 in cattle market and at same time sell one future contract at F equal to 100. One day later delivery the hogs in the future contract and collect rupees 100 at maturity. This is virtually riskless. Arbitrage pricing a future contract. Borrow and purchase stock today is equivalent to having the stock in 3 months. Equal to synthetic future. Note, no own funds used to create the synthetic cost of synthetic future. SF equal to S multiply 1 plus R into T, which is equal to 101. Arbitrage ensure quoted future price equal SF, where F equal to S into 1 plus R into T, which is equal to 101. Futures price equal to spot price plus cost of carry. Cost of carry equal to S into R into T, which is equal to rupees 1. and are hedging with futures. Arbitragers ensure F and S are nearly perfectly positively correlated and move rupees 1 for rupees 1. Where F equal to S 1 plus R into T, which is equal to S into 1.01, so approximately. So F1 minus F0 equal to S1 minus S0, that is dollar for dollar. Hedging with futures. F and S are positively correlated, create a negative correlation. If you are long spot, that is on one shares, then short the futures contract on the shares to offset the risk in spot or cash market. Hope that the loss in the cash spot market is partly offset by gain on the futures, dollar for dollar. Or final value equal to cash market value plus gain on futures locks in a non-price. Now simple hedging. On long, one share's spot price S0 equal to rupees 100. Fear price fall over next 3 months. 3 months future contract has current price F0 rupees 101. Aims, number one, to offset some of the loss in S by profit on F, or to lock in the final value of F0 rupees 101. Assume F and S are perfectly positively correlated. Strategy, long share plus short one future contract. Now simple hedging. S0 equal to 100 and F0 equal to 101. Loss in spot market offset by gain on the future. 3 months later spot price has fallen. Spot price suppose S1 equal to rupees 90 and future price F1 equal to 90. Note that we have assumed the contract is closed out just before maturity, so that S1 equal to F1. Gain on futures 101 minus 90 equal to F0 minus F1, which is equal to 11. Loss on the spot 100 minus 90, which is equal to S0 minus S1, which is equal to 10. And net profit F0 minus F1 minus S0 minus S1 equal to 11 minus 10, which is equal to rupees 1. Note that you can not guarantee that the hedge will give a net profit of 0, only that the net profit in the hedge will be less uncertain than simply holding the stocks. That is here a loss of rupees 10. Simple hedging. S0 equal to rupees 100, F0 101 can be locked in a price of F0 101. 3 months later spot price has fallen. Spot price S1 equal to 90, future price F1 equal to 90. Spot assets is worth S1 90 and we close out future position. So profit on future 101 minus 90, which is equal to F0 minus F1 equal to 11. Then final value equal to final value of stock plus profit from futures, which is equal to 90 plus 11. This implies by S1 plus F0 minus F1, which is equal to 101. Hence we have logged in the final value of F0 equal to 101. Then some algebra. Final value equal to S1 plus F0 minus F1 equal to 101, which is equal to S1 minus F1 plus F0, which is equal to B1 minus plus F0, where final basis equal to B1 equal to S1 minus F1. Note at maturity of the futures contract the basis is 0, since S1 equal to F1. In general, when the contract is closed out prior to maturity, B1 equal to S1 minus F1 may not be 0. This is called basis risk. However, B1 will usually be small in relation to F0. Source of basis risk is change in R, which is equal to F equal to S1 plus R into T. Why does the hedger close out before maturity? Even though you close out the contract, you still lock in a price which is close to the initial future delivery price of F0, which is equal to 101. But why not just take delivery at F0 101? Easiest to see if you are a farmer in New Orleans who want to sell his live hogs in 3 months' time when they have been attended up. If he delivers them in the future contract, he will have to send the hogs to Chicago, the delivery points. This is expensive, so instead he sells them in the local cattle market in New Orleans for S1 equal to 90, but he also makes rupees 11 cash profit on the futures. giving an effective price of rupees 101, which equals the F price had he taken. And now, questions, do it yourself. Question number 1, what is future contract? How it is different from forward contract? And question number 2, what is option? How it is different from swap? And that's it from session number 6. Thank you.